Thank you all for coming. Excited here to do some follow-up to support my office has been doing for a number of years. In 2011, we did an audit report regarding the repetitive reissuance of lost or stolen cars, which had really become abusive. Very pleased that John Family Services followed up on that report, implemented many of our recommendations, and subsequently, when we retested the issuance of cars, the number was dramatically reduced, indicating that some fraudulent activity was probably being avoided. Also, last year, we did release a report that was not designed to find individual cases of abuse, but was designed to test the controls in the system for supplemental nutrition, SNAP, often known as food stamps colloquially. And we found some troubling things. We found situations where we had transactions in the hundreds of dollars multiple times within a few minutes at the same retailer. Inexplicable and probably indicative of some fraudulent activity. We found a variety of other things. Many of you were at the press conference where we unveiled that report. So I'm not going to go through the various findings of that report, but I went down and testified in Congress about that report from the Agriculture Committee. This coming year, the Farm Bill, which is the vehicle by which SNAP is funded, will be reauthorized by Congress. So this is a year where this will be debated and policy enacted. While I was testifying, one of the Congress representatives asked me, well, what would you suggest that we do? Did I do that? I thought I'd just knock somebody's stuff off. One of the representatives asked me, do you have any recommendations for us? And we pointed to the things in a letter, which were our report. But I added that it would make a lot of difference if we simply added photographs to the benefit cards that are issued. And I was informed by the person who directs this program, who was in the room for the U.S. Agriculture Department, that's already permissive. So we came back and did some research, found out that other places are in fact doing this. And so today we're here to talk about a new safeguard, a piece of legislation that will be dropped today that will add a photo of the recipient or the authorized person on behalf of the recipient to the ID, to the benefit card. We believe that this will be helpful to avoid trafficking in cards. We know that there are trafficking in food benefits that happens around the state, and a photograph is a simple, straightforward way to deter that. When I was prosecuting attorney in Delaware County, and subsequently in my interactions with law enforcement, one of the things that became clear is that when you go in and kick over a crack house, you find four things. You find, aside from bad guys, you find drugs, you find money, you find guns, and typically you find EBT cards because drug dealers will traffic in them. We believe that the addition of the photo ID, or the photo on the benefit card, rather, will actually serve as a deterrent to trafficking in benefit cards that way. And I will leave some of the details here to my colleagues, but I'd like to just make a large policy argument here. The reason this is a good idea, as the auditor, I want to protect against fraud. I want to see tax dollars going where they ought to go, absolutely. As a citizen and a member of the law enforcement community, I'm interested in deterring drug trafficking, and that's a good reason to do this. But the most important reason to do this is because the legitimacy of the program is undermined by fraud. There is a disconnect very often between what politicians think is true and say is true and what people experience in their real lives. And if you go out and get away from the partisan politics or the Cap Square and actually talk to folks about what they think about the EBT program, the SNAP program, you often hear people talking about different kinds of fraud. Somebody coming through and buying 20 cases of Pepsi, for example. We know, for example, that Pepsi is resold and also bartered in some about poorer communities. I should say soft drinks rather than brand name. So the point here is every instance where there is something that they see or read in the paper, where there's some kind of law enforcement action, it calls into question whether there's fraud in the program, even if it's relatively small, it undermines public support for it. And at the end of the day, nobody in Ohio, nobody in America should be hungry, especially no child. And the support for this program will be eroded by it being abused. This is actually a program, this new idea of putting the photograph on the benefit card itself will actually help build public support for a program that helps so many people. So with that,